So the chapter 2, what we did was Nitya Dharma of the Jiva is pure and everlasting. So when you say Dharma, it is the intrinsic nature, that is Swabhava, right? That's what we really saw that. So there were two main questions that were, you know, that you must have seen that. Because if Jiva is infinitesimal, that means if it is like Anu Chit, right? I mean, it's really so very, very minute compared to the massive, the humongous size of actually Bhagavan. So if Jiva is infinitesimal, how can its eternal Dharma the pure and full? Okay, so then the answer that we really saw that was, okay, so the example was fire and sparks, right? So the spark has the quality of the fire, heat, light, burning quality, they're all, it really possesses from its main fire, from which that actually came out. So, but the amount of its power is different. Well, because a fire can actually burn everything, but a small spark may not be able to do so. Suppose you are actually, standing in front of the fireplace, and the spark actually just like that lands on your shirt, it just makes a small hole and it dies. So basically the quality is gone. But whereas that fire, the original fire, it will really burn it. Okay? So then another thing is, because if you see that, the fire fragment, the spark has power only if it is connected to the main fire. Otherwise, it just falls out and then gets extinguished. So this is another very important thing to remember, because the Jiva, as we are separate, we really are away from Krishna. That is why we are not feeling our original quality in full power. Okay? So then again, when we really talked about the different kinds of dharmas, as we have really seen, Dharma, which is the Swabhava, has three kinds. Nitya Dharma, which is eternal, and the other one is Naimitika Dharma, which is circumstantial, and the third one is Anitya Dharma. So Nitya Dharma is the prema to serve Krishna. So that is also called Vaishnava Dharma. So by Jivas, by nature, we are as eternal servant to Krishna. And our dharma is to really serve him in love. So the prema in the chapter, you know, like he was actually talking so much about prema. That is our treasure. Actually, the Jiva's treasure is actually prema. Then Naimitika Dharma happens when the Jivatma, you know, gets into Maya. I will actually show you how that actually gets into also. So then because of that, it acquires a temporary nature. So that temporary nature is actually Naimitika Dharma. So what is the, how it actually comes out, even though it is God-centered, but the Jiva will be really trying to enjoy. And it will also, asking for favors from different gods so that he can enjoy nicely. If you see that most of the religions, what we call, except Vaishnava Dharma is not a religion, it is an eternal dharma. So all the religions, mundane religions, what we really say, what do they do? Why do they go to the temple? Why do they worship? Just for the favors. They want to be happy. They want to be rich and famous. They want to be beautiful. They want to be comfortable, happy. So it's a self-centered. Okay, that is what the Naimitika Dharma. That is the most of the, you know, Jivas that are all God into the material world, they are actually seeing that Naimitika Dharma. Then the third category is Anitya Dharma. Anitya Dharma means those people who say there is no God, no soul. Who is that? Even, you know, Buddhists, for example, right? They say there is no God, and in fact everything is void. So that Sangaracharya, so he is Acharya who came that time to really rescue these souls, where the Buddhism was really very predominant. Okay, so that also we really saw that over there. Now the second question came. Okay, so these chapter 2 primarily deals with these two questions only. If Jiva is formed at constitution, how can its function eternal? Okay, he is asking, because the question is being asked, saying, okay, jiva all of a sudden just like that happens, right? Just born. So it really appears in the material world. It may be going through different, you know, universes after universes. But then he, you know, because we are thinking that it's somewhere, sometime, there is a beginning for the jiva. But the real, you know, the fact is, jiva is beginningless. There is no beginning. And Krishna is infinite, jiva is infinitesimal. So that is the only difference. And what is the age of jiva? Same age as Krishna. There is no beginning. It is eternal. Okay. So also that what is the eternal function of the jiva in its original form, in the Nitya Dharma, is a servant of Krishna. Krishna era Nitya Dasa. Nitya means what? Actually, eternally. And then also we really saw that there were actually two kinds of timing. Jadiya Kala and Chit Kala. Jadiya Kala is basically what we are actually seeing in our material world. Right? So we have so many light years or billions of light years and whatever. I mean, it's all so much of time that we are actually dealing with here. Right? There is past tense, there is present tense, and also the future tense. There are three kalas. That is called Jadiya Kala. Okay? Jadiya Kala means those kala, that kala means time, the times which are really attached with the material world. It is not really that in the spiritual world. Okay? Spiritual world it is Chit Kala. That means always it is present tense. That present tense, you know, we may think that, okay, so how does it look like? Actually, the reason is we cannot imagine that present tense. That Chitkala and our present tense is different. Okay, we cannot understand. Why we cannot understand? We are caught into this material world, and from here we cannot really see the spiritual world. So we have no idea how it will look like. Okay. So now the Jadiya Kala, why we are feeling that in this world, material world? Because of the Maya. So the Maya Devi, okay, who is actually Prakriti, who is actually, you know, creating all the material world for us and then binding jivas in this world. Okay, because we are under her, we perceive the constitution and time. What is the constitution? That was the question that Sanyasa Thakura was putting the question, because he was coming from Shankaracharya, the line. So he put the question. Okay, that means there was a beginning for the jiva. Actually, there is no beginning for the jiva. Okay. So the constitution that as we think, that really started, jiva started at some time. And there is a time running, and we magically just like that, you know, being born at certain time, is only because what? Due to maya, we perceive that way. Actually, jiva is not created, and it is eternal. And now, when did jiva fall? Creation is only a material concept for jiva. That's right. Again, I'm just, you know, reiterating some of the points which are very, very important. There is no time in the spiritual world. It's only Chitkala. Krishna and jivas exist only in the Chitkala. Chit sama. So then how can we really feel that? How can I really feel the spiritual world? That is the thing. We have to get into the Chit Samadhi state. Okay? How the Chit Samadhi state will come? That means we should have complete detachment from our material attachments. Okay? How is it possible? We are actually dealing with so many things here. Right? Every day. You know, I want to eat. I want this one. Stock market is going there. I have to really buy this thing. I want to buy that property, this property. So this is all. We have so much of attachment. Then you cannot get the given a glimpse of the Chit Samadhi. Okay. So how the Chit Samadhi is achieved? So the best possible way is by chanting in pure way. Pure chanting, not like just like that, keep on, you know, just chanting without any care. You have to do pure chanting. Suddha Nama. Okay. So then what happens? Our Suddha Swarupa is realized. You know, when you do the Suddha Nama, what happens? Our real Swarupa will manifest. Okay, we will see. Okay, as we go, In fact, if you read the chapter 1, there, Paramahansa Babaji, he was sitting in meditation, he was chanting. All of a sudden, his Nija, his Suddha Swarupa appeared. And he was all of a sudden in the spiritual world. And then, he was really talking all those things, and then he couldn't, then Sanyasa Thakura, who was actually listening to all the things, he could not believe what was going on. And he was talking about, he was telling, oh Saki, Krishna and Radharani, they are all sleeping, don't disturb them, Kakati, oh Mangi, this. So he was giving all kinds of things. And it was bizarre. And then after that he really faints. Because when you do pure, Suddha Nama chanting, you will get into Samadhi. Our Gurudev has really gone through Samadhi many, many, many times. Whole day he chants and then that's it. Then after that, he just goes off. And what happens then? He just forgets. There's no time. So material time actually completely stops. Then he really awakes back again. It will be there maybe night or something like that. All our Goswamis. Okay, just when they really tell the pure Krishnanama only once, they go into Samadhi. That is the Chit Samadhi that you are talking about. Okay, and can this Chit Samadhi be achieved by any yoga? Absolutely no. You saw that. Ashtanga Yoga cannot get to this. It is insignificant. It's a dust. Okay, it is actually supposed to be really realizing only for, taking your Kundalini all the way up to the Sahasrara and then get into the Brahman. We don't know. That is not what we are talking about. Chit Samadhi is nothing to the Brahma Samadhi. Okay, then Brahma Jnana according to Advaitis. Okay, Shankaracharya disciple, all those parambara, if you see that, according to them, Brahma Jnana is the topmost. Okay. And that's why the Maya wasam coming to. So, no. Brahmanyana also cannot get to this. So, this prema that we have been talking about, which is our Nitya Swarupa of our, Nitya Dharma of our soul, cannot be achieved by any this kind of yoga. Only, how what? That nine angas of bhakti. Sravanam, Kirtanam, so Smaranam, Padasa, Vishnu, Padam, so all that, all the nine angas, they have the power. Of which there is one stands supreme, that is Namasankirtan. Okay? Now, I will also quickly tell, I have 5 more minutes. I will tell you about, probably just go through the process of how a jiva gets contaminated, right? By the Maya. So if you see that from the top, you see the jiva in its pure state, it is in service to Krishna. That is its true ego. Okay, it says, I am a servant of my Lord Krishna. That is a Nitya Dharma, as we really saw. And those, first chapter, if you really are really very, very careful in going through that, you will all understand that one very, very clearly. Right? And now, some jivas, for some reason, why that for reason, jiva has freedom. Anything that has a consciousness automatically gets freedom. So freedom automatically sprouts. Because of the freedom, jiva, and also because jiva is anuchit, she is actually very, very infinitesimal, very small compared to Bhagavan, it has a weakness of what? Getting attracted by Maya. Okay. So that happens only when self-enjoying desire arises. If we do not get that kind of desire, saying that I want to enjoy separately, away from the Lord, then only the Maya is coming into picture. We really saw the thing again in the first chapter, quite some. Okay, so now what is the process happening? So very first thing is, the self-enjoyment desire arises within the jiva, and then it gets subjected to be under Maya. And then the subtle body with false ego is given. That is your second in between there you really see there. And then when it really further goes there, depending on which planetary system or which kind of material, because material worlds are like, see, remember, even our Brahmanda has what? 14 levels. So the different Brahmandas, they have different levels and different ways. the material worlds themselves are really humongous. We cannot even understand. So depending on where the Jivatma is supposed to be really born and going to live, then the grass body will be chosen appropriately. Okay, subtle body is same. Jiva, first thing is what? As soon as the desire comes, it gets into the subtle body, gets a subtle body, right? What is that one? What exactly the subtle body is? Mind, intelligence, and false ego, not the true ego, false ego. These three things constitute the subtle body. So this subtle body comes because of the self-enjoyment desire that arises, you know, for the jiva. Then the grass body actually after that happens depending on where the jiva is going to be enjoying. Okay. So when the grass body is really given, that time even the jiva is completely now deep rooted into material. He thinks that I am this body. I am a Brahmana. I am a Satriya. I am a man. I am a woman. I am a businessman. I am rich. I am beautiful. This and that, all kinds of designations are all the jiva assumes. And here we started with the prema, love of God, and that gets transformed into bodily lust. We call love, it is actually lust, greed, anger, and all these kind of bad qualities come. Why the bad qualities coming? Because we said we went away from Krishna. Bahir Mukha. We turned our face because we wanted to enjoy by ourselves. Okay. So this is how we all got into the mess now. So the only way to really get back is what? Surrender to a guru, and he will really give you the mantra to chant. He will give the seed, and that's the way we really go back. So the pure chanting of the Lord's name is very, 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 very crucial. Okay, so this is how we go back. Okay, thank you so much.